Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss on the last part of chapter 5, which is about data and base and data management. So we are going to basically cover these three main topics in our today's class. The first one is we are going to discuss about ETL process, then we are going to discuss about data mart and what's the relationship with data warehouse with that of data mart. And finally, we will be discussing about data mining. So there are just four slides which will be covered during this slide in this lecture. Okay. Now let's go to the first part, ETL. I already told you before, you are going to extract the data from different sources of the database. That's called extract. But you have to understand the ground reality that the format of the data from the different database is not going to be standard and consistent. There is a very big challenge in making sure that whatever the data you are going to have should be in standard same format. I explained to you in the last episode, for example, the date, some databases may use date, day, month, year. Some may use month, day, year. So if you are going to extract the data, it can cause a very big confusion because the meaning of the data in one database is different and the meaning of the data in another database is different. So transform is what? You have to change it into a way that it becomes uniform, like a standard format. Okay, what is data loading? It is nothing but to load into the end target which can store any data including files that are needed for making analysis and trends. So there are three steps in ETL. What is that? Data extraction. Extracting data from where? Heterogeneous or homogeneous resources. From same type of database or from different types of databases. That's one thing. Okay. A series of rules or functions are applied to for loading into up. That's what I told you. It should be actually like following rules and standard formats, so that the data is ready to be uploaded into the data warehouse. Okay, here the data is into which can be uploaded into any data store, including a file of a data warehouse. This is the idea of ETL. The next slide is about data warehouse and data marts. What is data warehouse? You already know. Data warehouse may be subdivided into data marts. What is data mart? Data warehouse can be divided into small parts and these are called as data marts. They hold the subset. You know what is subset? A part of the data which is originally stored in the data warehouse. Data marts hold a specific subsets of data of a company such as department or business process. Like we have a data warehouse, marketing data. Marketing department data. See, for example, marketing department data. Marketing department data can be stored in a particular, can be stored in a particular data mart. That means what? The data that you are going to store in data mart is going to be specific according to a nature of the data or according to the department where it belongs to. That's what you have to understand about data mart. Data mart is nothing but it is a subset of data warehouse. That means what? Data mart is a small part of the original data warehouse. Now look at this diagram. Now we have a data warehouse. In the data warehouse, we have different data like ERP data mart, CRM data mart, shipping data mart, purchasing data mart, like this. So all the data related to purchasing will be stored in the purchasing data mart. All data related to finance will be stored in the finance data mart. So this is the idea. Data mart is nothing but a subset of data warehouse and it holds the data which are specific to a particular domain or department or to a particular model that is adapted by the organization. Now the last part of the slide that I am going to talk is about data mining. One of the major uses of having a data warehouse is data mining. You know what is mining? You are mining means what? You are trying to find out something from the earth. Similarly, you are going to mine the data. For what? You are actually trying to mine the data and to reveal the hidden patterns and trends in historical business activity. Like for example, in every business activity, you see a trend. You know what is a trend? What's happening in every business in 1 month, last month, 2 months before? So you are trying to analyze the mood and the needs and the customer requirements of the customer. But for this one, we need to know the trends and we need to know the hidden patterns. So these two things are taken care by data mining. When you have this type of data mining, what actually happens is that it helps in making better decision making for strategic changes that are required, because we think something will work for us, but later on we found that it is not working well for us. So you actually can come up with new strategies because of having this particular data mining. It helps in finding the patterns and helps in business knowledge. I think with this one, the chapter 5 is complete, and please try to complete all these questions and try to make yourself ready. Maybe you will have chapter 5 and 6 in quiz 3. In the quiz 3, chapter 5 will be covered and chapter 6 will be covered. So I think with this, I would like to take a leave from you. Inshallah, see you in the next class. Thank you very much for listening.